Mr. Johnson, you're going against the view, one of the legends, living legends here and around the world, in the greatest arena in the United States. It must be special, no?
Oh yes, of course. You know, David Lemieux, again, I have the utmost respect for him. I find that other than just being a good fighter, he's also a good person. You know, David Lemieux shows a lot of respect for his opponent as well as he shows folks in general. But hey, dude can throw a nasty punch. So yeah, he is a legend in his own right.
But he's not invincible. What do you need to do to beat him?
How you know so well? He's not invincible, as we all are not invincible. But Tureano has a plan, and I'm not going to tell you my plan. But if you know boxing and you're a real boxing fan, then you know what Tureano can do. I know a lot of folks that have me at the underdog in this fight, but if you know boxing very well, you know very well. This is a terrible matchup for David Lemieux. And come Saturday night, you know, I ain't encouraging nobody to gamble. If you gamble on David, I think you're going to lose. In fact, I know you're going to lose.
Well, what makes you feel so sure about that?
Well, you know, I know what I've done and I know what I can do. And what's about to take place is how I feel. And I've never felt this great. I've never felt this strong. I've never felt this fast. I've never felt this healthy. I've never, ever felt this excited to step in the ring with another heavy punch such as David Lemieux. And I'm telling you, it's a perfect matchup for me.
Good luck, sir.
Nah, there's no luck in this. I'm blessed.
What do you think is your greatest strength coming into this fight?
My greatest strength inside this fight is something that a lot of folks haven't seen yet. Power. Power. Devastating power. Power that shocked me. So come Saturday night. Oh, should I end up speaking a little bit of my secret, eh? But yeah, come Saturday night, you're going to see a little bit of power from Tureano.
Do you think Lemieux is looking past this fight to get a fight with Canelo? Do you think Lemieux is looking past the fight to get a fight with...
No, I don't think Lemieux is looking past this fight. I think Lemieux knew that we were on a head-on collision for quite a while. And, you know, there were a few times that we were supposed to buck heads. You know, unfortunately, I can't say that he turned it down. Probably his camp thought that it was not a financial move. I can't blame them, you know. But be that it is, you know, he knew who he was supposed to fight, and he knows that it's going to take place at some time in life. So, no, he's not overlooking me. So come Saturday night, I'm sure that he's going to bring more than just his A game. He's going to bring the best David Lemieux you've ever seen before.
Johnson.
So if you're victorious this Saturday night, is the fight with Canelo in the future something that interests you?
Of course. You know, but hey, as it is, you know, boxing is also a business. And here it is, you know, I consider myself a small fish in a big tank, you know, and I have no problem with that. You know, when my time comes, I'll take the bone and I'll chew it. And definitely, Canelo is one that I have my eyes set on, focused on like an eagle. You know, so I'm interested, die hard, focusing, zoned in on Canelo. But I'm going to take care of business come Saturday night, and that's right now is my main priority.
Johnson, what does it represent to you fighting under Canelo and Rocky Fielding, like those, you know, those big names?
Well, you know, it's an honor. You know, Canelo, you know, he has just proven himself to be one of the greatest and the best fighters there is. You know, he just defeated, you know, Triple G. Triple G, you know, many claim that he's the boogeyman, the most invincible one, the undefeated fighter with such incredible knockouts. But as it is, you know, Canelo did what he had to do and he won the fight, you know, and fighting under the Rocky and Canelo card is a plus. But fighting here at the Madison Square Garden for my third fight, in front of the New York fans, I'm telling you, this right here is the pinnacle of any professional boxer's career. So indeed, you know, it's an honor, a privilege. I mean, it's a blessing to fight here at the Madison Square Garden. That right there is my focus.
Definitely, you know.
As you said, it's your third time fighting at MSG, whereas for Fielding and Canelo, it's their first time. What advice do you have for them fighting in the most iconic venue in America?
Well, I would advise to them, you know, embrace the crowd, embrace the fan, because they are the ones who are here to watch you fight. And don't hold back. Give them 100%, as I have done in my previous two fights here where I came out the victor. Why? Because I gave it everything I had.
Thank you.
God bless.
Thank you, John.